we are ready for la pasta, gli spaghetti alla carbonara.
What is spaghetti alla carbonara?
So we have this is the guanciale, which is the cheek of the pork.
Pecorino romano,
two eggs, which I took off from the refrigerator earlier, and black pepper.
So now I'm gonna start cutting, slicing the guanciale.
Here is the guanciale. You see how greasy it is? Now, I have to cut first la cotica del guanciale. La cotica del guanciale, which is the skin. And I'm gonna use it to grease the pan. A guanciale is not easy to find. I found it in Petaluma. And obviously, the better you put the quality, better quality, the best is the dish, obviously. So I'm gonna cook slowly the guanciale in the pan, starting stir fry very low, 140 Fahrenheit at the moment. I have to take the grease out from the guanciale. The guanciale is going slowly. Now I'm gonna grate some pecorino cheese, okay? In the meantime, I forgot, let me put the spaghetti. Let me throw the spaghetti. These are cooking quickly. Okay, a fist of spaghetti in the boiling water where I put a fist of cold salt. And the spaghetti, let me put 10 minutes at least, because they are very good. 11 minutes I put for the spaghetti. Now, let me grate parmigiano. No parmigiano, pecorino romano. The eggs. Now it's time for the eggs. Okay, two eggs. And I'm gonna use only the yolk. Il rosso d'uovo. And I have to whisk the eggs, okay? To make a cream. It's very difficult to make a carbonara, we will see. We will see. Now, let me tell you that I have to add some pecorino, and then I will continue to whisk. Let me tell you, the name carbonara, there are lots of debates where it comes from. To me, it's coming from 19th century, 1840, 1850, because in Roma area, cacio e uova, the pasta cacio e uova, it was already existing, was already there. They call it carbonara. Carbonara is the name is from charcoal men, so the coal miners. You can call coal miner. Miner's spaghetti, okay? Gli spaghetti dei carbonai. Also, carbonaro in Italian was also a secret society, like a lobby, political lobby society during the 19th century that worked to help Italy being unified, okay? The other idea is that carbonara was invented in Rome during the Second World War, when American soldiers, they would come and they would bring bacon and eggs, and a trattoria in Rome would there is la carbonara, a trattoria in Rome. It seems that they used bacon and eggs to make the carbonara, but for the Italians, for the Orthodox,
you cannot use anything but the Ten Commandments, okay? So no bacon, no garlic, no olive oil, only what is in the Ten Commandments. Okay, the alert is done. 11 minutes, the pasta is ready. I just tried it. Now what we do? We are gonna transfer the pasta in the pan with the guanciale, okay? We are gonna transfer the pasta, the spaghettoni, in the guanciale pan, okay? So that it will go with the grease, will cook with the grease of the guanciale, you see? I have to be quick. And then I'm gonna put a little bit of water, salty water from the... Not much, we'll see. These are like bucatini, that are very big spaghetti. I brought them from Italy. Okay, and now you see the cream. It's wonderful. I love them. The cream is coming from the starch of the spaghetti. Okay, and now, still hot. While it is still hot, I'm gonna take off from the fire. Okay, switch off the fire, and I'm gonna put the egg cream. I do like this to help mixing. It looks wonderful. I don't need to add anything because the cooking of the spaghetti, it looks very nice. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna use this one and this one to get out from the pan and put it here. Now this is for a fancy dish like the ristorante. You do like this, okay? You're gonna put a little bit of black pepper, not much, and pecorino, a little bit more of pecorino, okay? So I'm gonna show you the dish as a restaurant, Sicilian restaurant would make for spaghetti carbonara. Here it is. And Marco is gonna try from... Oh, let me add... Wait a second. Bruno, aspetta. I'm gonna add some pieces of... obviously. Pieces of guanciale. I think these are good for a contest. Ladies and gentlemen, these are good for a contest. Look at that. These are spaghetti carbonara, okay? Fatti da Marco, and they are very good. But before saying that, I'm gonna try directly from the... Wine. Arrivederci dalla casa di Marco. Ciao!